just an accident. What happened to I went to the school, which was just in the street corner. So I just walked in one day to find out if there's any vacancy, because I was sitting bored at house and it was just a few steps from my house, literally. So, and these people just looked at me and asked me, what is my qualification? At that time, I was more of an artist. You know, it was all nice to just walk in that place, and they told they have a vacancy for an art and craft teacher. I can teach this drawing to everybody. I can do a little bit of craft. And it was a part-time job, and it was very nice just going there for 3 hours. I was observing. I was a good observer, and I was looking at all this happening. I mean, the teachers teaching there, going busy, you know, talking about board exams, that, this, as if that's so important. And art and craft was not at all very important. And then I thought, why can't I do this? Chemistry was my major and my passion, and my school, TVS Madurai, we had a lovely teacher called Mr. Balasubramaniam, who, you know, made chemistry such a magically interesting subject. The person who made me look at chemistry, but that was due to Mr. Balasubramaniam. So that passion was there, and when I saw this lady teaching there, I was in my mind, you know, maybe if I had this opportunity, I will do it this way, and maybe it will be more better. You know, that sort of thing started happening, and immediately applied for my MSc. As soon as I finished my MSc, I thought I should do a BEd because I wanted to teach. So then I decided it was going to be my line. So enthusiastically, I finished my BEd and immediately did a MEd also, because those years were only a part-time teaching. My threshold of that boring thing came up, and I quit my job and came home and, you know, did my MPhil in a college within 2 weeks, without any plan of mine, without finishing my MPhil. I was into Vidya Mandir as a postgraduate teacher. So there started my, you know, the way. So it was 50% accidental, 50% intentional. And the chemistry classes which were taught in that first previous school were the ones which inspired me to take up chemistry as my main teaching subject. I had never taught chemistry in the 11th standard. And my first period was 11B. And I was a class teacher for that class also. And, you know, it was just being pushed into the water to learn swimming. The explaining part was not difficult. The subject was not difficult, but how to go about was absolutely, I had no idea at all. Had a conversation with others, then learnt my way. And from then on, every time I had a doubt, I used to ask. And I understood this very clearly, especially during my Fulbright tenure, where they say you'll have to ask, only then it will be answered. If you keep it within you, you won't be answered at all. In my mind, I was thinking somebody will come and tell me, you know, you're doing so and so, you better, you know, work and things like that. But then when I realized that I had to ask for help when it is needed, I had to consult, then it gave me a total different perspective. And I saw that it was received very well by my seniors, and they guided me into, you know, a better teacher. The second role model or my mentor in school was Mr. Reddy, who was a reservoir of knowledge. You know, I was so amazed by the depth of knowledge he had. And he was such a soft-spoken person, but none of the students opened their mouth in his class. He was one of the best teachers. My mentor and my teacher was my inspiration.